Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If it's your first time here, my name is Gladys Lynn. Yes, Lynn is my husband's name, which I love so much. I even loved the name before I got married. Yeah, you know the whole story. But if you're new here, yes, that name was given to me as soon as I entered into the family, before we started up the dating and everything stuff. So I got the name. And it officially belongs to me now since I'm married here in China. And today I want to share with you, well, marriage is not hard, but marriage is not simple. Sometimes there are things we expect in marriage, sometimes we don't know what we are going in for, and there are things you'll be like, oh, I wish I knew this before getting married. So today I want to share with you some of the things I wish I knew before getting married here in China. You know, I'm an African girl from Uganda, so I migrated from Uganda and I settled here in China with my husband, where we are living. Yeah, sometimes I live in Kunming with him, sometimes I come to the village where he works. So there are little things I wish I knew. We didn't talk about them, I didn't ask, and I wasn't interested, I should say. Why? I wanted just to get married to the man I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. When I was getting married, I never knew I would not be able to work. In Uganda, I wasn't doing something that is so serious, but I used to do my wigs, I sell them off. In Uganda, we say, so me, I started business marketing. So I loved things dealing with businesses, and I always love to be self-employed, so I would always get things and I sell them off. I know you might ask me, in Uganda, what were you doing? I was self-employed, I was doing my businesses, this and this, but I was earning something, like, you know what I mean, putting your hands on something, which is not the case here in China. According to the kind of visa, I have a marriage visa, and that means if you have such a visa, you're not supposed to work. It's illegal to work using that visa. Even the state, the laws clearly that you're not supposed to work with that kind of visa. And even last time when we were called at the police station, they told me, Gladys, with such a kind of visa, you're not supposed to work. Even if you're going to ask me who get to know that you work, there is a way these people are. They are there own securities. Someone might inform the police, ah, we saw maybe a black girl working there, we saw, you know, things can spread around, you never know. So they'll always get to know. By the way, before you think of doing something, just know China is ahead of you. They always know something. So I'm a stay-home wife, I have a lot of time, so that time I use it, yes, to try to learn the language, to try to learn how to cook. But by the end of the day, there are some responsibilities on my shoulders at home. My husband can help me out if I tell him, but you know, sometimes you don't want to burden your partner asking for this and this, telling your husband about the family problems, about the family issues and all that. So there are sometimes you'd be like, I can't handle that, I can't do this, just because you can't work. And there are sometimes when you feel like you want to have your cup money as a woman. So YouTube is now my work. That's why I always do vlogs and upload them. So kindly support your girl. You can watch the videos until the end. And yeah, you can also become a member of this channel. I was told after 5 years, you can get a residence permit. Should I say it like that? Like something like a residence, you know? Yeah, after some time. Which will be, you know, yeah, it's not so far, but it's long. So that takes me to be bored. Hey, my God. Housewives, how do they manage them? I think they have kids to, you know, to play around with. They have friends to visit and all that. Unlike me, who doesn't have friends in China? Yeah, I have a few, but they are far from me. The only thing we can do, we can just talk on phone. So you find yourself so bored, so lonely, and the friend you have is your phone. Phones become your best friend if you don't have friends around. Even, you know, you get addicted to your phone and you get addicted to your phone. So you become so lonely when your husband is at work, when, you know, like sometimes when I'm with my mother-in-law, we try to talk a few words, but you know, when you don't understand the language, the conversation can't be that deep and deep and deep. So even if I call my friends, we can only use translators, maybe like so a few words, and be like, what is he trying to say? Oh God. So you become so lonely, so bored. You watch movies, you get done with them. Yes, you're going to tell me why shouldn't I take a course? You can't study from morning to evening, and I have the rest of the hours until my husband gets back, until I talk to him. Anyway, what I'm trying to tell you is, there are times when you feel lonely. So I never knew it's going to be a kind of life here in China. I thought things would be fun, I would be going out, I would be, you know, moving there and there. But if you don't know the language, even traveling becomes complicated, becomes hard. You don't know why you don't know where to go. You're scared of traveling alone. Yeah. Another thing I wish I knew before getting married here in China, the language barrier. I knew I don't speak Chinese, but I never thought it's going to be this hard. Yes, we try to communicate with my husband. It's not hard between us, by the way, communicating. But there is a times it gets off us. He says something and I really don't understand it. Maybe I even misinterpret it, and sometimes you find yourself getting pissed because of it. Yet he was meaning something else, but when you sit down and you talk about it, you'll be like, okay, this is what you meant. I got you wrong. So communication sometimes becomes a bit terrible. Yeah, the culture difference. Whoa, I wish I studied and researched more about Chinese culture. I was so excited about a few things that they don't do in China, yet we do them in Uganda. Hey, like kneeling down. In Uganda, we kneel. You kneel where you need to and where you don't have to. We do kneel. Serving your husband, greeting your dad, doing this and this. That's a culture of kneeling down. But since here in China, we don't kneel down. That excited me. I was like, we don't kneel down. So you say hi. But it becomes sometimes a case. It's okay to wear short things in China, which is not okay to wear such kind of short things when you're with your in-laws. That's more so the mother-in-law, the father. How do they see you wearing a short skirt? But there are times when I wear a short, you know, a short, something short, and my mother-in-law tells me you're looking good, and I feel like I'm uncomfortable. So I didn't know, like, their culture, it's going to be a bit hard, you know. I don't know if I need a time to learn more about it. When my in-laws come home, father-in-law, we are not supposed to sit together. We are not even supposed to dine together. So sitting next to him, hey, I feel like I'm shaking, I'm shivering, as if I'm on thrones. It becomes kind of disturbing. So there are a lot of things that we don't do in Uganda, but here they do them, and it becomes it becomes hard, not in a bad way, but you feel like you're not yourself. That's not something you could be comfortable with. Since I'm groomed from Africa, from Uganda, that I'm not supposed to do that. The pressure. Hey, no one is putting me on pressure. Not my husband, not my mom, but the pressure I'm getting from on myself, it becomes too high for me to handle. On like learning the language, learning how to cook, trying to make it, you know, to make me fit. It's not like I don't fit, but I don't know how I can make you understand. Yes, I thought I have ever been with them, but not in this kind of being a daughter-in-law. So I thought, okay, I'm married, things are going to be just the way they used to be. My husband never goes somewhere without going with me as long as we are together. Yeah, he tells me, tomorrow we shall be going to such and such a place. So we go together. But you feel the pressure of fitting in that place, what they are saying. Hey, So you start smiling. You even get to see people, they are talking about you, but you don't know what they are saying. So you feel pressured about a lot of things. Like, what are they thinking about me? What are they saying? You get the pressure to learn, the environment, everything. Yeah, so I thought this wasn't something that would be kind of hard, but I feel like I wish I knew and I prepared myself enough. Yeah, but what happened. We are not going back, and we are already here, so we have to move with the, you know, the rhythm. We have to make it work. We have to stabilize. We have to learn how to make things work here. Yeah, for the culture, I know it can kind of be a bit different. Sometimes I know we shall argue about them, but nothing to do. That was it. Comment down below if there are things you never knew about them before getting married, and you're just facing them after getting married, and you're like, I wish I knew the things before getting married. But one thing I believe, you can never be prepared enough. If you're going to a warfield, just get your gun and go. The rest, you'll see what happens from there. Anyway, thank you for watching until the end. Thank you so much for always sharing, liking, and commenting on our videos. We do appreciate that, and we don't take it for granted. It's your girl, Gladys Lynn. Let's meet again in our next video. Bye-bye.